Did my massage ruin my Botox? I got a massage today, 5 days after receiving Botox injections in my forehead and eye area, and I think that it ruined my Botox. When I got home, I looked at myself in the mirror and had a large dent on my forehead. I didn't think much of it until I realized that I could move my entire forehead up and down. Last night, my forehead was frozen, and today, I have full movement in my forehead. I emailed my injector today and asked to see her next week, but I am shocked that this happened. Is this normal?
Thank you for your question. You stated in your question that you had a massage where approximately 5 days after you had a Botox injection where you couldn't move your forehead, and after this massage you state that you have full movement of your forehead and you appear to have a dent in your forehead. And you have a scheduled appointment with the person who injected your Botox in about a week. So you're asking about, did the massage ruin your Botox? Well, I can give you my perspective as a practicing doctor. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon, practicing in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. In fact, botulinum toxin or Botox was actually something I've been using for patients since 1993. And our specialty of oculofacial plastic surgery, we're actually amongst the first few doctors to actually use Botox for medical conditions such as benign essential blepharospasm. And so since then, I've been using Botox pretty much every day. So just as a review to understand how Botox works. Botox is referred to as a neurotoxin. Botox, Dysport, Xeomin, they are all different versions of a botulinum toxin. And so this works by actually attaching to receptors in the muscle. And there's a point to this. When the Botox does bind that receptor, that muscle is effectively relaxed or paralyzed depending on the number of receptors that are affected. Now, that being said, when we do Botox injection in our practice, I explain to patients that the onset of the benefit can be, you can begin to start noticing things as early as 1 day, but it's typically 3 days, and the peak of its effect, which has been confirmed in our medical literature, is about 2 weeks. We see our patients routinely in about 2 weeks just to see how things look and to do any enhancements if appropriate. The point is that when physiologically speaking, it doesn't quite stand to reason that a massage would negatively impact the pharmacologic or the medical effect of the botulinum toxin. Now, there is an infrequent group of patients, or small group of patients, I should say, who actually develop a resistance to botulinum toxin and will develop a tolerance. In other words, their body actually can make antibodies to the Botox or the Dysport or the Xeomin and actually prevent it from working. Now, this is often seen in people who have been using it for a long time, but it is still relatively rare. So I'm not going to say that that's the situation with you. As far as the cause of an indentation in the forehead, you know, a lot of times when a person's forehead muscle, the frontalis muscle, when we talk about Botox in the forehead, we're relaxing the muscle that elevates the eyebrows, and that muscle is called the frontalis muscle. When the muscle is more relaxed, it is possible to actually see the underlying structure, sometimes in patients, especially if the skin is relatively thin, of the actual contour of the skull. So there are certainly some questions that remain to be resolved. And the absence of a photo, I can't really speculate that much further. But as far as a physical massage, I can just tell you that when we were first using Botox, and we were using it for medical patients, We would actually go from room to room and inject patients and have them leave and not do any kind of special aftercare. When Botox was started to be used for cosmetic reasons, kind of the passage of information between doctors fell into one of two camps. One camp would say, don't move, don't do anything, don't even lay on your face. And the other camp would say, move the areas a lot so that it really, really works. Well, from my experience, and this is over 20 years of injecting patients with Botox, I think that once the drug is delivered into the muscle, it will do what it's supposed to do. It rarely has an effect on an adjacent area or spreads to other areas of the body. And so I would say at 5 days, you are probably in a fairly safe zone. Again, in our practice, we get to know our patients very well, and we see them on a regular basis. And so I get to know what the right dosage is and what the right locations are that create the effect that my patients like. Hopefully you're doing the same with your doctor, so that your doctor knows your face and knows what is unusual and what is normal. So if there is a true indentation, you may want to evaluate what the cause can be, but it's not likely that it is Botox. As far as the return of movement, and in this time frame, it also makes me question whether or not the dosage was at the level that would be most effective for you, or maybe it's worth trying a little bit more, another injection, just to see if you get that movement relaxed the way you like it. So once again, I don't think the massage has had a negative effect on the pharmacologic effect of the Botox, but I think that meeting with your doctor about your results and looking back at your own history will probably be of some value in addition to a physical exam. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. And thank you for your question.